Right now, though, the time is just gone 10 to 8. Another day, another door, because it's time to open the next door on our Mad Vent calendar. Every show until Christmas, we've been catching up with some of the people that you nominated for our Make a Difference Awards earlier this year. Who's behind the door today? Who is it? Hello, anybody there? It's Jake Oakley this morning, the chairman of Sheffield Steel Kings Ice Hockey. The Steel Kings are a para ice hockey team who allow people of different abilities to get on the ice, and they were nominated for our Together Award. So let's just take a moment to remind ourselves as to why.
It's what I've always sort of strived for, really, is to kind of build a programme that basically accepts everybody, no matter what their background in any kind of thing. It doesn't matter about sexuality, what their ethnicity, whether they've got disability, or body. None of that really matters. It's just about getting in a sledge and being one. And, you know, we always sort of set out to be family. And, you know, I really believe that despite the growing numbers, and you think it would kind of get harder to keep that, but actually, you know, just more people join and they buy into what we're about, because they are welcomed in such a way that when the next new person comes down, they welcome them in the same way. So the family just gets bigger and bigger and bigger. And it's amazing the people that we have involved.
How do you encourage, you know, people with lower body disabilities to come out, come and try the Steel Kings out?
Well, really, it's about exposure. We're trying our best to kind of get our name out there as much as we can, promote the sport, just be very active in terms of social media and our visibility generally. We have some great fans, great supporters, sponsors as well. So we just do everything we can to work really hard, both on the ice and behind the scenes as well, just to try and grow the sport. And the more people that know about it, the more chance we've got of finding those future superstars of the game.
And Jake's with us now on the show this morning. Good morning, Jake.
Good morning.
I thought you was laughing at me then, but it's just your phone. I don't know if you're fiddling with it or something. I was like, what's that big loud noise?
Sorry, I'll sit still.
Well, it's all right. You get excited and move around. Remind us why you wanted to get involved with the Steel Kings, Sheffield Steel Kings.
Well, my backstory is that I've always been an ice hockey fan, and I also had a motorbike accident. So, you know, kind of my two worlds sort of collided. And when I found out that Sheffield were going to try and set up a para ice hockey team, I knew I wanted to get involved and at least sort of throw my support behind it. And then, you know, like these things do, you sort of, it snowballs and you end up getting involved in lots of different things, and you know. Here we are, sort of nearly nine years later, and yeah, and I'm sort of like looking after everything in some respects. Yeah, but I wouldn't change it for the world.
Well, you do a really important job, because you are actively breaking down barriers within sport, which is, it can never be a bad thing. Can you just emphasise why that is so important?
Well, sport is an amazing thing, you know, and it really does actually bring people together. And we're in a very sort of fortunate position, and it's sort of the ethos of the club has always been that everybody is welcome to play para ice hockey as long as you can play hockey. You know, it is a fast-paced, physical sport, but if that's the sort of thing that appeals to you, then, you know, we kind of open our doors and welcome you down. We want to see people get involved in our sport, and it really doesn't matter what somebody's ability or disability or their background or anything like that. It really doesn't matter to us. As long as they're prepared to play, you know, our fast-paced physical sport, then we're happy to have everybody involved as we possibly can.
We know that para ice hockey as well, Jake, it's really, really grown over the last couple of years. What do you think's the driving force behind that? Is it just more awareness that it's a thing and it's there?
I think there's been a drive generally towards sort of more understanding towards disability sport as a whole. And then from our point of view, you know, we try to be very sort of social media savvy. We try to kind of put out plenty of content that kind of keeps people informed. We put on exhibition games. We actually have one on this weekend on Sunday, where it's sort of free for people to come down. So even if you're just slightly curious, it doesn't cost you anything to actually get involved and you know, come down, some free family entertainment, and you can go away kind of going, oh, I really enjoyed that. But, you know, that 2 hours of sort of free hockey, and it sort of opened my eyes to disability sport. And the great thing about sort of para ice hockey as well is that once everybody's in a sledge, it's quite difficult to sort of tell actually, you know, who is disabled, because you're all just playing the sport. So it's great.
That's it. So for people that have never seen it visually, what does it look like? So you are literally in sledges or like toboggan like things. What does it, how do you move on the ice without banging into each other? How is it a dance, Jake? You explain it to me.
Well, because it's for people fundamentally that have a lower body disability, we sort of take away the use of, you know, people don't have to be able to use their legs to be able to play the sport. So people sit in metal frame sledges. There's a couple of skate blades underneath sort of the seat that they sit in. Feet go on the front sort of thing. And basically you push across the ice with two sticks. One end has some metal picks that dig into the ice. So it's very upper body orientated, basically. You have to be able to hold the sticks at the top to be able to push yourself along. And then when you're kind of stick handling, shooting, making plays with the puck, you slide your hand down the stick to be able to pass the puck around. But like I say, it doesn't take anything away from the physicality that ice hockey is. And, you know, it's a fast sport. It's actually much faster while you're playing it. When you're watching it in the stands, it looks a little bit slower. But when you're playing it, it really is fast, because you're down at that level, and people love it because it is so skilled.
People might be listening now thinking, oh, I've never thought of giving that a go, but I'd love to. Would you be able to sort of train them up and stuff?
Of course, that's what we're all about. We have people who are sort of new to our club and the sport, on a weekly basis, come down to training, right through to people that now go on to represent Great Britain on the world stage at World Championships, and hopefully maybe one day, you know, Paralympics. So yeah, we have a full range of players and people, and we want that next superstar to come in who might be listening to this, who, you know, might be missing, you know, part of their leg, or have some other kind of disability that means they might be a wheelchair user, but they have, you know, full use of their kind of their arms and core and things like that, and they want to think about getting involved. We have inclusive skating sessions on a Monday where people can come down and give it a try at Ice Sheffield. There's no pressure from the Steel Kings at all. That's an Ice Sheffield thing, but it means they can try the sport. And then we also have our own weekly training. And if anybody is really curious, we have lots of content out on all the usual social media channels, including YouTube, where there's lots of our games and things like that. And yeah, there's lots of opportunities for people to find the sport and see if it's for them.
Jake, thank you very much. Jake Oakley there from the Sheffield Steel Kings, and we'll bring you another door on our Madvent calendar tomorrow.